See, they're developing their young players now, but yeah, it does take my mind back. I've been pretty well pleased with myself today. I was able to remain unbiased, and I keep singing the praises of the North Launceston Footy Club, who thought terrific. But just a personal opinion, it's been a fantastic day, a great crowd, etc., etc. But well, I might as well start. I don't think this is good enough. You got these 500 or 600 people on the ground. There's no podium for the presentation. There's no where the chairman can get up there and present the medals. And that's very disappointing. These blokes have worked a lot hard, and one of the great memories you do have is going up and standing on the podium. Let's listen to Roddy.
Full credit to my fellas for just hanging in there and giving it their best shot. Okay. Firstly, I'd just like to get my assistant coach up here, Grant Fagan. Now, without his work, we certainly couldn't have been here today. And half this cup is certainly his.
I think one of the other things, Rob, about this Clarence side is they've got a lot of local product. They've got many of the players from the Eastern Shore. They've got a handful of recruits, okay. And that's really the way Tassie footy ought to be. We've got enough homegrown product to do things like today. Great effort.
And I believe the job they have done today, all the hard work has paid off. Firstly, Daniel Holm.
Well, Daniel Holm was an exciting player today, and they had their problems early, but he just got better as the day went on. Maybe an AFL career awaits him.
Matthew Jones.
Another one of the homegrown boys you were talking about, Gary.
Yeah, had a Scott pretty Adams. Fair day today.
Fantastic game from Scott.
Probably the turning point when he went to centre forward, Troy, would Hello. You think? Scotty Wade?
Scotty Adams.
Scotty Adams, sorry.
Yeah, I thought so, but that was, you know, Brownless was good. But yeah, Adams is, well, you know, he's had his critics because of his inconsistency, but he stood up today in the grand final, and that's what he'll be remembered for.
Took 7 marks when he did go to that centre-half forward spot, so that's a terrific performance.
They had to take Proctor off the ground because Scott was too mobile for him, and it was one of the significant moves of the game.
Petey Ritchie there, number one. He was busy today in the forward line, kicked 4 goals. Scotty McCallum, good game.
Yeah, terrific game. I thought he was very ordinary early, didn't get into the game, but a fantastic performance by him to lift himself, and that's a credit to the young kid, and that's a test of character for him. He'll remember that because, like the team who was down early, he was one of the players that had to put his hand up after half-time, and well done to you, son.
Look, while they're going through the players and giving them each their medals, their thoroughly deserved medals, how do you feel like out there at the moment, both Robbie and Davo, having won the flag? You know, it's all over for the season. You can't go any further than that. You've won the premiership. What things go through your mind at the end of the day after winning?
Gee, it's a bit of a relief more than anything, Wilkie. I can recall on a number of occasions players standing around saying, well, what do we do now? You know, it's all over. We've got the medallions. We've got the premiership cup. What do we do? And as many of the players that we've coached have never been there before, and it's a great experience for everybody. And it certainly is a huge relief. And to be there as the last team out on Saturday in September is a great feeling, but more than anything, a relief.
Yeah, you're very pleased for your players because you've asked them to do things since day one. These blokes have probably started training in November. You've asked them to do this, that and the other thing. They've responded. Basically, the blokes that have responded are the blokes that are out on that ground. And they've worked very well as a team, very hard as a team. And, you know, to Roddy and the boys, congratulations. Darren Winter, there's Darren Winter. A lot of publicity before the game about what he was going to do, but the good thing about him is that he played footy and he played it well, and probably one of the best players on the ground.
Andrew Scott Jr. there, Jim, and he was the only change that Clarence made to its lineups in the last 5 weeks, and the omission was Jason Love, who played in the reserves today. So he's been a great inspiration, I've been told, by a number of the Clarence players. Andrew Scott Jr., just because of his desire to get into the senior team.
But the good thing about the Roos and also North Launceston is they've really come good because of the homegrown players they've got. We've talked about it, haven't we? But you just go through that lineup, and probably 15 of the lineup are homegrown lads. And it goes to show you shouldn't go out and about trying to buy players. You should look what's in your own backyard, foster that, and this is what happens.
You're spot on, Wilkie, and you can see the players there, all pretty happy, big smiles. And the clubs that really do something with their younger players in their district are the clubs that are going to be the clubs of the future.
Now, one of the big honours, sorry, Robert, no, one of the big honours today is the equivalent of the Norm Smith medal, the Darryl Baldock medal. I'll put you all on the spot. Who do you think? Gary, you're first. Bad luck.
Oh, so I'd almost go for John Cullen off the half-back line.
Robbie?
Well, I thought Winter was in the game early when Clarence were playing badly, and I think that because of his discipline and the way that he controlled himself, to the credit of his team, I'd punt on Darren Winter.
Jim?
Well, I'd probably give it to Scott Adams, because even though he had a very quiet first half of football, I think it was his second half which really got the rules back into it.
And I was just about to go with my mate on the left-hand side, Darren Winter.
No, you weren't.
And he's won it.
You got Scott Adams written down there.
There, a Darryl Baldock medalist has been won by Darren Winter. And congratulations to him. He got so much publicity during the week because of the clashes in the second semi-final. And let's have a listen to what he has to say.
A great bunch of blokes. Bad luck to North Launceston. I feel sorry for you, but it's the way it goes. We're the best, and stiff shit to the rest.
Well, Darren,
don't think he's going to make it as a poet, Rob, but terrific effort today, wasn't it, by him?
Well, he'd had a perfect day then, hadn't he?
Oh, we've wrapped him up, and I hope he doesn't let go with a poem now. Let's go down to John Kenny, who has Darren Winter amongst the mayhem now. Over to you, John.
Darren, congratulations on the premiership. Congratulations on your performance. It must be very pleasing you right at this very moment.
So I don't think I've got many words to say how I feel at the moment. It's the greatest experience of my life. Just happy we won.
And I think it says a lot for you. What your teammates think of you, the response when you were announced as the winner, it's obvious you mean a lot to this side, and they have admiration for you.
I think honestly we mean a lot to each other. I think that's why we won. We're very close. And we love each other.
Great. Well, that's the second player that said that. Cooney said the same thing at three-quarter time. A great personal effort, a great team effort. Well done.
Thanks very much.
Well, Darren Winter leaving John Kenny there, and this is a magic moment. I've never experienced this, of course, but take us through running a lap of honour with that Premiership Cup, Robbie Shaw.
Yeah, it is a magic moment, and one that the players will cherish. They'll all get the video of the game, no doubt, but look, I don't want to be negative, but I just think this is disappointing. I think the crowd control's ordinary. The fact that the players weren't put up on the podium to present their medals individually, so that all the crowd... Like, we're in a very fortunate position here. We can see the players, we can see everything. There's probably 5,000 or 6,000 people still here that couldn't see a thing. And I feel a little bit sorry for Ridey. Hasn't played in a premiership or a grand final until today, and to walk up onto that that platform and receive the trophy is something that he would remember, and to receive it standing on the grass in the middle of 600 people is, well, I don't think it's on, and I'm very disappointed, and it's just a little damp on what has been a fantastic day. I don't know what Dave thinks.
Look, I concur with those thoughts, Robbie. You really do need that podium out there so the players can be presented to their fans. The moment when you stand up there and accept the Premiership Cup is something that I'll always cherish, and I think Stevie Wright has missed out on something special today simply because that podium wasn't there.
Well, that walk up those stairs to get your winning medal is the moment. Not out here doing the lap. The medal, get the medal put around your neck. Everybody's seeing you and applauding you. And it's been a great day. The TFL could be congratulated. The crowd's fantastic. Anyway, well done to Clarence.
Well, fellas, we've only got 40 seconds or so left, so I just want to make a few thank yous. Thank you very much, Robbie, for being a part of us today. It's been something special, and glad for your time.
Oh, yeah, it's been a special day, not only because Clarence won, but to work with Davo and yourself, and Wilco, a lot of fun, and a terrific game. Haven't seen a better game for a long time.
Thanks very much to Gary and Jim for your tireless work throughout the team. We've had a great year in 1993. Also to Peter Chisnell, who's been with us on the boundary line, John Kenny similarly, and also to our hard-working production team. Rob Klein has been a tremendous influence on us all. He's assistant Brigitte Lowe, and the hard-working OB crew. Too many names to mention, and I won't forget our statistician, Rick Finlay. We've enjoyed it. See you later. Oh.
Good on you, boss.
How audible is the wretch?